Departemen Teknik Mesin ITS. Nah, di sini saya akan
Recording in progress.
Berbahasa Indonesia sekaligus berbahasa Inggris. Nah, I would like to remind you about the rules of today's webinar. Participant can speak when allowed by the moderator. Jadi, partisipan bisa berbicara saat dipersilahkan oleh moderator. Yang kedua, partisipan are required to be on camera while talking to the moderator or presenter. Jadi, apabila para hadirin ingin mengajukan pertanyaan atau ingin berbicara dengan moderator ataupun presenter, harus meng-on-kan kameranya. Nah, during the event, participants are asked to mute the audio if it's not needed. Jika tidak ada hal yang diperlukan, saya mohon kepada para hadirin semua untuk nge-mute audionya masing-masing. In this webinar, contain three presentation, where each presenter will provide the presentation is about 15 minutes, and then continue with discussion session about 35 minutes. If you have any question during the presentation, you can write up your question in the chat room. And I will read for you in the discussion session later. All right. Yang terhormat Dr. Ato Setiawan selaku Kepala Departemen Teknik Mesin ITS, yang terhormat Dr. Unggul Wasiwitono selaku Kasubdit Admisi ITS, the Honorable Professor Norbert Gottwald as presenter and he is lecturer from Wismar University, Germany, dan seluruh hadirin webinar hari ini yang berbahagia. Pertama-tama, marilah kita ucapkan puji syukur kehadirat Tuhan Yang Maha Esa yang telah memberikan keridhoannya, bimbingannya, kesehatan, sehingga kita dapat menghadiri acara webinar hari ini tanpa suatu halangan apapun. Let us thank God for giving his blessing so that we can attend today's webinar. On this webinar, we have several agenda as follow: opening, sing national anthem, speech from Dr. Ato Setiawan as the head of Mechanical Engineering Department, presentation from the presenter. His presentation will take time about 15 minutes, continuing discussion session about 35 minutes. And the last is closing. Baiklah, para hadirin sekalian, mari kita mulai acara ini dengan mengucapkan basmalah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Nah, sebelum kita menyanyikan lagu Indonesia Raya dan beranjak ke ini acara selanjutnya, dimohon kepada para hadirin untuk duduk dengan posisi tegak dan siap untuk menghormati lagu kebangsaan kita. Setelah itu dilanjutkan dengan dilanjutkan ke acara inti yaitu presentasi dari materi para presenter. Nah, hadirin dimohon untuk duduk tegak dengan posisi siap. We ask the audience to sit in an upright position and be ready to honor our national anthem. The audience is requested to sit up straight with a ready position.
Mana nih kita TV-nya? Nah ini.
Yang ku cinta,
Indonesia raya, merdeka merdeka, hidupa Indonesia raya. Indonesia raya, merdeka merdeka, padaku negeriku yang kucinta. Indonesia raya, merdeka merdeka, hidupa Indonesia raya.
Oke, okay, thank you. Baik, selanjutnya saya persilahkan kepada Kepala Departemen Teknik Mesin ITS untuk memberikan sambutan sekaligus membuka acara webinar hari ini. Kepada Dr. Ato Setiawan, saya persilahkan. Oke, okay, alright. I invite the head of ITS Mechanical Engineering Department to give a speech as well as open the webinar event today. Dr. Ato, time is yours.
Masih mute. Pak Ato masih mute, Pak Ato. Oke, terima kasih Saudari Vika atas waktunya. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. For Professor Norbert, let me speak in Indonesian first. Sorry about that. Terima kasih kepada Profesor Norbert, kepada Bapak Warek 4 ya, Pak Bambang Pramujadi PhD, kemudian ada Pak Dekan, Pak Wawan Aris, karena terlalu banyak Bambang ini, Pak Wawan, Pak Wawan Aris, kemudian Pak Unggul sebagai Kasubdit admisi di ITS ya, kemudian Bapak Ibu dosen Departemen Teknik Mesin, kemudian para peserta webinar kelas internasional Departemen Teknik Mesin pada sore hari ini. Alhamdulillah pada sore hari ini atau siang hari ini kita bisa dipertemukan dalam acara webinar kelas internasional yang dibuka atau ditawarkan oleh Departemen Teknik Mesin. Kelas internasional ini sudah memasuki tahun ketiga untuk IUP dan tahun kedua untuk John Degree. Kemudian saya ucapkan terima kasih kepada Pak Unggul ya, yang nanti sebagai narasumber admisi IUP dan John Degree di ITS, khususnya di Departemen Teknik Mesin. Kemudian I would like to thank you very much to Professor Norbert Grunwald who want to join this afternoon webinar with the title is International Class Program from Department Mechanical Engineering ITS. This is the joint degree between Mechanical Engineering Department ITS with Bismarck University in Renewable Energy Bachelor Program. Thank you for Mr. Norbert. It's my pleasure to hear from you to presenting regarding the program renewable energy cooperation between Bismarck University and Mechanical Engineering ITS. Itu saja saya pikir. Jadi terima kasih, mudah-mudahan webinar kali ini bisa memberikan sosialisasi maupun informasi kepada masyarakat ya, terutama bagi anak-anak atau putra-putri yang ingin memilih sekolah yang terbaik bagi putra-putrinya. Ya, jadi ini adalah kesempatan kita menyampaikan ke masyarakat bahwa Departemen Teknik Mesin mempunyai kelas internasional yang berkualitas, kemudian yang bisa dibanggakan dan diamanai ya untuk mendidik putra-putri Bapak Ibu sekalian untuk menjadi the real mechanical engineering dengan wawasan global. Begitu saya rasa. Terima kasih kepada semuanya. Mari kita simak paparan daripada narasumber Bapak Unggul kemudian Profesor Robert dan dari Head Mechanical Engineering Department. Terima kasih atas perhatiannya. Mudah-mudahan acara hari ini lancar dan bermanfaat, berkah bagi kita semua. Dan terakhir, sekaligus acara ini saya buka dengan bacaan Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Terima kasih Saudara Vika.
Baik, terima kasih Dr. Ato Setiawan yang telah memberikan sambutan sekaligus membuka acara pada siang hari ini. Hadirin yang berbahagia, acara sudah dibuka. dan kita akan masuk ke acara inti yang kita tunggu-tunggu bersama. Untuk materi pertama akan dipresentasikan oleh Kasubdit Admisi ITS, yaitu Dr. Unggul Wasiwitono tentang IUP, atau International Undergraduate Program and Joint Degree Admission Program in ITS. Kepada Dr. Unggul, waktu dan tempat saya persilahkan.
Terima kasih, Bu Vika. Good afternoon, everyone, and good morning, Prof. Norbert. Yeah, I think in German it's still in morning. Please, I share the screen first. For today's webinar, it's also broadcast in YouTube. I will give an overview and student of admission of the ITS International Undergraduate Program and Joint Degree Program. First, I think most of you already know where ITS located in Surabaya. Especially the eastern part of Surabaya. Located in a green campus, leafy campus, around 200 hectares. And why study at ITS? Mostly we think about accreditation and ranking, and ITS is one of the best science and technology university in Indonesia. And this year we also have the from the THE, Time Higher Education Impact Ranking, we rank number one in Indonesia. And then we have also many achievement in research. Our researcher is expert in their respective field. And also ITS is become a best innovation management. Campus with the best innovation management in Indonesia. And we have also many collaboration with industry and also research institution in international or national. And then we have also many collaboration, international consortium with European University, and then ASEAN is we have as ACNET ANGTEC is ASEAN China Network for Cooperation and Exchange among Engineering and Technology University. Currently from Indonesia only ITS member of this consortium, and then we also member of Australia Indonesia Center is a consortium between 7 best university in Indonesia and 8 university in Australia. And we also have many collaboration not only in a consortium but U2U like with the Wismar University. And about IUP, International Undergraduate Program, and also Joint Degree Program. For Joint Degree Program, ITS has this three department or pro study program. Marine Engineering with Wismar University, Naval Architecture, and Mechanical Engineering. What the difference between Joint Degree Program and International Undergraduate Program? For Joint Degree Program, when you register, apply for this program, already that the international exposure for joint program is it's joint degree program. And for international undergraduate program, for the international exposure, you can choose. Can be student exchange, short program, intensive, and then if the department has a joint degree program with overseas university, you can also choose to join the program as international exposure. In terms of flexibility, IUP program is more flexible for the international exposure. And for IUP study program, in ITS, currently only 17 department that offer the international undergraduate program, that's statistic. Then all department in the Faculty of Industrial Technology and System Engineering offer IUP program, mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, engineering physics, industrial engineering, and material engineering. Then all department under Faculty of Civil Planning and Geoengineering also offer IUP program. This one, civil, architecture, environmental, urban and regional, geomatic, geophysic, engineering. Then, besides having joint degree program like mechanical engineering, naval architecture also offer IUP program. Then, department under Faculty of Intelligent Electrical and Informatic Technology, that is Electrical Engineering, Informatic and Information System. This also offer IUP program. And then Business Management under Faculty of Creative Design and Digital Business. So in total, IUP has 17 department that offer this IUP and 3 department that offer joint degree program. Yeah, mechanical and naval architecture both offer joint degree and IUP program. Yeah, later on more detail about mechanical engineering joint degree and IUP program will be discussed. Okay, and then this one, the international undergraduate program is that the English as a language of instruction. Yeah, and then as I mentioned before, that you can choose international exposure, can be student exchange or program, yeah, or joint degree program, yeah, specific for a certain study program. Then also in this program, we'll invite a lecturer from overseas university to teach in ITS, yeah, because English as the language of instruction for the admission, yeah, the general requirement is this one. English certificate, yeah, is compulsory, and then academic report for our transcript, and you can use SAT test, yeah, or for Indonesian nationality student can use UTBK, yeah, ujian tulis berbasis komputer. If you not have this score, you can take ITS academic test. We call it TKA, test competency academic ITS. And then for the IELTS, yeah, you can take the test. Sorry, for the English, yeah, you accept TOEFL, IELTS, or TOEIC. And one more is the new is Duolingo test score. For tuition fee, the international undergraduate program is 25 million plus institution development fund, and then for joint degree, especially for mechanical engineering, is 30 million. Yeah, slightly different. Okay, that for admission. Yeah, all the admission process is through SKMP, Seleksi Kemitraan Mandiri dan Prestasi. Yeah, you may choose for if you want to choose IUP or JD, you only can take Seleksi Kemitraan or Seleksi Mandiri. Yeah, more information can be found in the website. What is SKMP? Yeah, all the application process is online. Yeah, this one is the requirement. We also accept IGCSE, Cambridge IGCSE. And then you need your academic transcript. And we also consider academic or non-academic achievement. You can upload the certificate if you want. For example, the science fair or something. For example, also if you have achievement in the sport or in art, you can also use it. And then you need to write a motivation letter and also English proficiency certificate. Yeah. For English proficiency certificate, yeah, you can take this one because right now is a pandemic, yeah. But many institution offer online tests such as ITS TOEFL, and then we also ITS TOEFL Home Edition. This one Duolingo English test, yeah, you can take test online and will receive the score, the result between 2 days. and you can also take IELTS, by British Council or IELHF, and language institution in public university throughout Indonesia. We also accept the certificate from language institution in public university. Especially for ITS, we also have ITS Language Center, and they also have not TOEFL, STEFL, Test of English as Foreign Language. Yeah, it's slightly different, almost the same as TOEFL. You can visit this website language@its.ac.id. Yeah, this one for English language proficiency requirement. Okay. The admission schedule for IUP is, we have first batch, already last February to March, and then for the second batch, and the registration is started it's May, up to June 17, and then there will be an interview, on June 24th, and the announcement will be in June 2029. And first, the administration procedure, you need to take, we call it KAP PIN and also payment code. Yeah, through this website, and then choose pendaftaran online. Yeah, then choose seleksi kemitraan mandiri dan prestasi. Yeah. If you, and this one, you can enter your full name, then date of birth, nationality, and then choose select that you will memilih joint degree. You will choose the joint degree or kelas international. Enter your email, and then this one for security CAPTA, and then click register. You will receive an email and also the payment KAP PIN and payment code. Using KAP PIN and payment code, you pay the registration fee at the bank, But please make sure that you enter the correct because in this website, the smets.its.ac.id is the portal for the admission, all the admission at ITS, not only bachelor degree but also master and doctoral degree. So make sure that you choose the correct link, because the registration fee cannot be withdrawn. And then after you pay at the bank, then you can log in again, by entering your KAP and PIN. After the payment is complete, then you can the website in the online applications, so something like this, that your payment is successful and you can complete the to fill in the information need to for the registration, photograph, biodata, personal information, the previous study school, and also the academic transcript, score for UTBK, TKA, or SAT or IGCSE, and then the selection. Within the selection type, kemitraan or mandiri. And then if you take kemitraan, you need to define what is the ITS partner, kemitra, and then you may choose study program. You may choose up to 4 study program. For example, first is mechanical engineering joint degree. The second choice is mechanical engineering IUP. The third choice is, for example, marine engineering joint degree, and then industrial engineering IUP, for example, up to 4 in the choices. And then also this one, you enter the ITF. If you have achievement, in art, in sport, in academic, or in science competition, etc., you can upload the certificate, and then verify that all the information you already fill in is correct. If you already check it, double check it, and believe it's correct, then you do a confirmation. So after you do a confirmation, you click the confirmation, you can download the registration card. Okay. Yeah. So make sure that you save and print the online proof of registration card. Yeah, because this card will be used for the re-registration process if you accepted at a ITS. Yeah. Then about this one, ITS academic test or test kemampuan akademik is conducted online because now is still pandemic, yeah, COVID-19. The requirement is personal computer or laptop with webcam and Windows 10. Yeah. Then software Zoom meeting and also make sure that you have enough bandwidth on the internet. Yeah. The registration process slightly different, yeah, with the SKMP. Yeah, you register to this link, and then after that you will receive an email activation the email is consists of activation link. So you need to activate your account by clicking the activation link. After activating your activation, after activated your account, login again. Yeah, to fill in all the information required, okay, and then if already complete all the requirement information required to fill in, then you may pay the registration fee. Then after you pay the registration fee, you login again to download the test participant card and just waiting for the test schedule. The test is scheduled in start from June 14 until June 19. Yeah, more information about the KA, test kemampuan akademik, yeah, can be found in this link. Yeah. Okay, I think that's all, Pak Ato. Yeah, join us. Yeah, unleash your potential, inspire other, and also striving together to develop our country. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Unggul Wasiwitono, for nice information about international class admission, requirement, procedure, and selection in ITS. All right, participant, if you are interested with this program, don't hesitate to join with us. If you have any question, you can write up in chat room. And we move to the next agenda that we're waiting for is about IUP and joint degree program in mechanical engineering by Dr. Ato Setiawan. Dr. Ato Setiawan, time is yours.
Okay, thank you very much, Ms. Vika. I will use the mixed language, yeah, because some slide I take from the ITS Directorate of the Global Cooperation in Steel Indonesia. Okay. Oh. Okay, this slide is already see. Okay, thank you very much for the participant, for the Professor Nobert and other colleagues in the ITS. This afternoon, I will explain and describe the international program which offered by Mechanical Engineering Department ITS. This is two international program, that is the international undergraduate program and joint degree with Bismarck University at the moment. This is signboard in mechanical engineering in the future. It is now still progress. Okay, I would like to show the profile of Department of Mechanical Engineering. Yeah, this is the oldest department in ITS and founded in 1957. The Department Mechanical Engineering Department is the oldest and the quality department because some of the grant is already taken from mechanical engineering. First one is the EDP loan in 1980. The second one is crash program bachelor from Indonesia government 1986, and Q quality for undergraduate education funded by World Bank in 2000, and we have created the new program for the women because we think mechanical is very hard, yeah, and we see that actually not we use the muscle in the process of education, but rather than mostly using the brain. So we call it in Women in Mechanical Engineering in 2004. And the last is the I'm here, Indonesian Managing Higher Education for Relevant and Efficient, funded by the bank 2007. All of the funded is show that the Mechanical Engineering Department is good, one of the good mechanical engineering education in Indonesia. And in 2019, we offer and open the international program, that is the international undergraduate program, and the joint degree with Bismarck University we open in 2020. Accreditation, we receive the 4 times for A accreditation, yeah, the what call the higher of achievement, yeah, and we also received the own QA for bachelor, and we already received also in this year is IAB, this is the international accreditation, and this year beside the A accreditation from Ban PT, we also in process of accreditation ASIN, yeah, for master degree in 2021. We have lecturer about 48, yeah, 48, and 10 professor, 34 doctors, and 5 ongoing completing of doctoral program. In mechanical engineering, we have a good academic atmosphere, so the student able to creative, innovation, and compete in international workplace. Among the number of students, all is most more than 1,100 students. And we have already have more than 6,500 alumni spread in of the all of the world. This is the comparison between IUP and joint degree. This is most question is addressed in this two program. Yeah, this is we split in five academic indicator. Yeah, first of all is curriculum. For the IUP, this is the regular curriculum that is the same with the bachelor program in Indonesian program, but in IUP, all of the practicum, all of the lecturer is conducted in English. Yeah. But for the joint degree renewable energy, cooperation between mechanical engineering department ITS and Bismarck University, we split mix lecturing 60% from ITS lecturer, and also the subject, and the rest of the 40% is come from Bismarck University. On the language, both is using the English during the lecturing in class, and lecturer in IUP, all of the mechanical engineering lecturer, but delivery in English version. But for the joint degree, this is the mix. 60% of the lecturing is conducted by mechanical engineering department lecturer, and the rest is 40% professor from Germany will come to the mechanical engineering ITS. So usually Bismarck University send 2 or 3 professor each semester to lecturing in ITS. The fourth is the international exposure. Yeah, this is many opportunities to getting experience in international program. Yeah, for the student, for the IUP, this is mandatory to get the international exposure, and there are many program can be take, yeah, from the student exchange, internship, short program, final project, study excursion, international competition, and maybe can be joint degree. Yeah, this is the option. Yeah, because if get the joint degree, maybe more than necessary to more budget. Yeah, to take lecturing in abroad. This is international exposure should be taken by the international undergraduate program. But for the joint degree in renewable energy, mostly all of the activity can be done in ITS Surabaya, but in semester 7 and 8, maybe any opportunities to the student to go to the Germany to take internship and final project in Germany. Usually 5 up to 10 best top students can go to the Germany if the financial capabilities is allowed. And certificate, I think IUP have one ITS international certificate, yeah, if you don't take the joint degree. But if you take the joint degree as an option, I think will receive the certificate from the ITS, international certificate of ITS, and the partner of the ITS. But this is the optional, yeah. But for the joint degree, will receive two certificates, one from the ITS and the second come from the Germany universities, maybe from Wismar University. Yeah. And it can be noted, but if you take joint degree in IUP, maybe cannot take joint degree with Wismar University atau in renewable energy, because the curriculum is different, yeah, from fourth semester is different between IUP and joint degree. So it is difficult to IUP student to take joint degree with Wismar University unless before third semester, maybe possibly can change, yeah, maybe can change because the curriculum or subject is still the same. Sorry, this is for Television Indonesia. I take from Direktorat Kemitraan Global for Internal Socialization. Kelas yang dilaksanakan sepenuhnya dalam bahasa Inggris, termasuk pengerjaan tugas, praktikum, laboratorium, dan tugas. This is all of the activities, academic activities is using the English. Selama perkuliahan, mahasiswa diwajibkan mengalami international exposure, jadi adalah diwajibkan, jadi mandatory, sekurang-kurangnya satu kali dalam bentuk bisa joint degree, student exchange, final project, internship, short program, maybe just study excursion. Ya. Jadi, this is mandatory for the international university program student to take international exposure. Ya. So many international exposure can be taken. International exposure selain hal di atas, misalnya study excursion bisa dilakukan mulai semester 1. Ya. Jadi usually international exposure can be taken after the third semester. Joint degree, ya. Joint degree ini memang kita sedang merintis, ya. Jadi kita sedang mencari mitra dari luar negeri, dan ini cukup alot, ya, cukup rumit kerjasamanya karena harus berbagi kurikulum dan berbagi waktunya. Ya. Jadi di sini ada beberapa alternatif, ya, mengikuti program 2+2, artinya 2 di ITS, 2 di sekolah mitra, atau 3+1 atau 3+1 dengan mitra ITS di luar negeri dan mendapatkan 2 ijazah dari ITS dan mitra, ya. Jadi John degree ini mungkin nanti akan ada beberapa universitas yang bisa diambil, tetapi tentu saja mempunyai konsekuensi daripada budget ya. Jadi kalau universitas di Australia kita kemarin menjajaki cukup mahal ya, cukup mahal. Jadi mungkin yang agak murah biasanya di sekitar Asia ya, ada Asia. Jadi Taiwan, Korea, Malaysia, Thailand mungkin masih affordable begitu ya. Tapi kalau yang di Eropa, Amerika sama Australia biasanya cukup mahal anunya, tuition fee-nya, juga living cost-nya begitu. Ya. Student exchange, kegiatan pertukaran mahasiswa ke universitas mitra luar negeri selama satu semester atau bersifat reciprocal. Kemudian study abroad, kegiatan pertukaran mahasiswa universitas di luar negeri tidak bersifat reciprocal selama satu semester atau lebih ya. Jadi sekarang ini dengan program pemerintah Merdeka Belajar dan Kampus Merdeka, sekarang ada beasiswa yang diperebutkan ya, tapi ini seluruh Indonesia, jadi seperti IIMSA ya, jadi kemarin apa, Indonesian International Mobility Activity ya, jadi ini beasiswa yang disediakan oleh kementerian yang bisa diperebutkan oleh semua mahasiswa di seluruh Indonesia ya, jadi mempunyai kesempatan kuliah satu semester atau dua semester ya, saya lupa, satu semester ke universitas 10 top university, jadi 10 perguruan tinggi terbaik di dunia gitu ya, jadi untuk memberi pengalaman kepada masyarakat Indonesia. Final project ya, pelaksanaan tugas akhir di universitas mitra selama satu semester atau lebih, internship atau magang, ini kegiatan magang di luar negeri baik di laboratorium maupun perusahaan mitra. Kemudian suatu program kegiatan pertukaran mahasiswa ke universitas luar negeri dalam jangka waktu yang pendek. Jadi mungkin secara sekilas program IUP dan DJD ini hampir sama. Bedanya kalau DJD ini sudah spesifik dengan universitas Jerman, ya, khususnya di Wismar. Sedangkan kalau di IUP ini bisa bervariasi universitas yang bisa dipilih. Ya, jadi mungkin itu aja. Jadi saya rasa mungkin nanti yang joint degree pun juga tidak tertutup kemungkinan untuk bisa melakukan short program maupun student exchange ya, selama kompetensi ataukah subjeknya itu adalah sama ya, jadi mungkin ini tetap terbuka ya. Nah, ini beberapa internal exposure yang sudah diikuti, study exposure, international short program at ITS, International Conference, International Competition, FITS, International Workshop di dalam negeri, International Competition. Jadi sekarang di ITS banyak sekali program-program internasional yang bisa dimanfaatkan oleh mahasiswa ITS umumnya, dan saya rasa IUP sama JD punya potensi yang besar. Karena apa? Karena kapasitas atau kemampuan bahasa Inggris lebih bagus. Jadi seharusnya saya katakan ya, dia harusnya lebih menang daripada masalah reguler. Jadi ini tantangannya. Nah, untuk yang joint degree, ini sementara kita punya kerjasama dengan Wismar University Germany. Ya. Tetapi kita akan juga membuka kemungkinan kerjasama dengan universitas Jerman lainnya yang mempunyai subjek ataukah bidang renewable energy ya. Jadi nanti bisa jadi adalah combine dari beberapa universitas Jepang. Nah, kalau IUP ini adalah kurikulumnya sama seperti reguler, cuma disampaikan dalam bahasa Inggris dan semua tugas praktikum maupun final project-nya dalam bahasa Inggris, tapi di joint degree ini kita punya prodi ataukah mungkin apa bidang studi ya, jadi konsentrasinya itu di renewable energy ya, sehingga di sini kita bagi tiga sebenarnya ya. Jadi ada mata kuliah dasar teknik mesin, ini menjadi tanggung jawabnya mechanical engineering ITS, kemudian yang membentuk kompetensi renewable energy ya, jadi 40% ini adalah menjadi tanggung jawab Wismar University ataukah nanti universitas Jerman yang lainnya. Sedangkan muatan nasional maupun lokal ada sekitar berapa itu? 33 ya. Jadi 33 ini pun dengan program pemerintah yang Merdeka Belajar dan Kampus Merdeka ini bisa digantikan dengan mata kuliah lain yang terkait dengan Merdeka Belajar dan kampus Merdeka ya. Jadi mungkin mungkin sekarang ini opsi pilihan dan alternatif untuk membentuk kompetensi seorang mechanical engineering cukup beragam begitu ya. Jadi mungkin cukup banyak sekali sarana atau prasarana yang bisa dimanfaatkan. Nah, ini adalah kurikulum yang saya katakan tadi 60% dasar teknik mesin yang menjadi tanggung jawab dari Mechanical Engineering Departemen ITS, dan sisanya 40% fokus kepada renewable energy yang menjadi tanggung jawab kompetensinya kita berikan kepada Universitas Jerman, khususnya Wismar University ya. Jadi yang putih ini adalah mata kuliah dasar teknik mesin. Kemudian yang mulai semester 4 nanti akan ada profesor Jerman yang akan datang ke ITS untuk menyampaikan lecture-nya, kuliahnya. Jadi ada wind energy offshore and onshore, waste energy, waste to energy ya. Nah, ini adalah beberapa yang kita tandain. Yang kuning adalah mata kuliah yang akan diampu atau di delivery oleh Profesor Jerman. Nah ini jadi sekilas adalah 1-2 ini perkuliahan sama sampai semester 3 sama antara Reguler atau mungkin antara IUP sama CD. Yang beda nanti adalah mulai semester 4 yang joint degree mulai beberapa mata kuliah sudah disampaikan oleh Profesor Jerman, sedangkan yang IUP tetap menggunakan kurikulum mesin ITS yang reguler tetapi disampaikan dalam bahasa Inggris. Semester 5-8 mata kuliah Renewable Energy Technology diambil oleh Dosen Wismar University, ada internship, ada final project yang nanti 5-10 mahasiswa terbaik bisa pergi ke Jerman ya untuk menambah pengalaman internasional dan bisa melakukan magang maupun final project di Jerman. Begitu presentasi dari saya, program yang kita adakan di Departemen Mesin. Thank you very much for your attention. Terima kasih Miss Pika atas waktunya.
Okay, all right. Thank you, Dr. Ato Setiawan, for nice information about international class in Mechanical Engineering Department, such as international undergraduate program and joint degree program with Wismar University, Germany. So the participant, if you are interested with this program, please join with us and take a good adventure, another good education. So take this opportunity right now. Okay, all right. The last presentation from Professor Norbert Grunewald from Wismar University. He will present about joint degree program with renewable energy program. For Professor Norbert, the time is yours.
Thank you very much. Many, many things are already said about this joint degree, and I can add only a few things what is important for the part from the German side. Yeah, that's a joint degree, mechanical engineering, renewable energy systems. It's an international study program, and international study programs have for every participant, successful participant, many, many advantages. He gets a double degree, that's very important. He gets this Indonesian degree and he gets a German degree. And the German degree is valid in the whole European Union. That is an entry card for enter the European job market. That is one very important thing. When we concentrate Wismar's part, German's part, will be the renewable energy system part. As you heard already before, the four semester are mostly in Indonesia. The rest are also in Indonesia, but are with a lot of German professors coming to Indonesia. They will come for 2 week and run one block course. That is the thing that you do not have the whole semester, a few hours, you will get it in the so-called block course mode. When we look for this renewable energy systems, as the name says, that are systems of renewable energy, and then we need an interdisciplinary approach. The first part of the study program is mostly mechanical engineering. This part, renewable energy systems, is a mixture. We have mechanical engineering involved, we have electrical engineering involved, and we have nautical engineering involved. All three disciplines bring their specialty in what renewable energy means into this program. And in addition, we do not have only professors from Germany on board. There will be also some lectures from industrial experts. And I think that makes this study program very, very interesting, because they can talk about real applications, real industry, how it goes. One thing what we also focus in our renewable energy system are the skills. We are not looking so much for repeatable knowledge, what you can find on any website or on many websites and get it from there. We will concentrate on skills, competences. And the most important skills, what you need in the future, can I share my screen? Is this possible? Can you see my screen? This one? Yeah. If you look, can you see it? Can you see the screen?
Yes.
Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
Okay. Then the thing is, I will make it in the full mode. Here you see the top 10 skills of 2025. That is what industry or the enterprises normally expect from the job applicants. That is not so much the technical knowledge. It is really much more this personal skills. We call it also transversal skills. That is analytical thinking, innovation, active learning, and learning strategies. And then three very important things are complex problem solving, critical thinking and analysis, creative originality and initiative. Yeah, that is from the World Economic Forum. But these five topics, what I mentioned now, they are listed here on the top, are the skills, the same skills for 2020 and now for 2025. That means when you are finishing your study, that is around 2025, then you need such skills. That means we will, can skip this slide again, we can go to the normal mode. We will focus on such skills. That means we have not only technical subjects integrated into the curricula, we have also integrated the so-called transversal skills with this complex problem solving, critical thinking, analysis, and active thinking. That's a very, very important part of our curricula. Why it's so important? If you look now for, start with international companies. International companies, when they make their job interview, they mostly look for creativity, critical thinking, and if they can solve even little puzzles. It's not the thing that they look for mechanical stuff in the job interview, because the mechanical stuff, they expect that you know it because you go run to this course, and if you have missed something, you can find it on the internet. It's not so a big problem. But these things are important for your lifelong job. And do not expect that you stay in one job for your lifetime. It will be changed because the time is changing so quickly, jobs are changing so quickly, the environment is changing so quickly. And that's why you need this creativity, this active thinking and innovation, active learning. That is the most important thing. But it's also important if you want to create your own enterprise. You need this complex problem solving. If you have a new product or a new enterprise, you need this five transversal skills here on the top, no problem. And even if you work in a company as an employee, every employer will be more than happy if you can develop this company more in the selection. Yeah, as you also heard, if you choose this study program, there's also an offer to study in Germany. The best option, what I always recommend, is to take the last semester in Germany, because the last semester is this final year thesis and industrial placement. There you have a chance to get some courses, stay in the company, to work in the company, and to make your final thesis, to get a good overview about Germany or industry in Europe. Yeah, okay, that's so far from my side. I think it's very, very interesting program, and it offers you a lot of opportunities for your future career. Thank you very much.
Okay, that's the presentation from Professor Norbert Grunwald. Thank you for your very good presentation and nice information about joint degree in renewable energy at Germany, especially Wismar University. May all of us get the value and benefits from the presentation. Okay, let's join to their class later and improve our skill competencies. Okay, all, right now is the time for discussion session. First, I will start with the three question from the participant. If you have any question, please let me know and put your hands up, or you can write up your question in the chat room. Okay. Baik, para hadirin semua, jika ada pertanyaan, silahkan untuk angkat tangan atau on cam, atau bisa juga menulis pertanyaan lewat chat room. Nanti pertanyaannya akan saya bacakan. Have any question? Okay, have any question? Para hadirin, apakah ada pertanyaan? Jika ada pertanyaan, saya persilahkan bisa angkat tangan ataupun langsung on cam, langsung memberikan pertanyaan. Bisa pertanyaan kepada Dr. Unggul, bisa ke Dr. Ato, atau ke Profesor Norbert.
Gunakan bahasa Indonesia, enggak apa-apa.
Ya, gunakan. Menggunakan bahasa Indonesia enggak apa-apa, bahasa Inggris juga enggak apa-apa. Saya persilahkan yang ingin bertanya. Yang mau join di International Class, di ITS. Jadi program ini sangat menarik, jadi untuk para hadirin semua bisa ini apa menanyakan semuanya. Jadi misalkan ingin tahu gimana nanti programnya ke depannya, terus tentang biaya ataupun yang lain, nah itu bisa ditanyakan. Okay, this one have one question from Aryo to Professor Norbert. He asks like how many living allowance in Germany for the student if they are join the joint degree program in Germany.
The question, yeah. Where they live?
Yeah, how much is the living allowance?
Okay. If you look for the German cost, I know that to live in Germany is not so cheap. But however, we have students hostel. We will offer them student hostel accommodation. The student hostel cost, we have only single rooms. We have no shared rooms in Germany in the student hostel, but they are in a unit, let me call this, there's two or three students in a unit. They have a joint, everyone has a single room for themselves. He has a joint bathroom and a joint kitchen. The price for such a accommodation is monthly €240. And what you need for living costs in Germany, it's around €500 per month. Now we have student catering at the university. We have shops where you can buy everything what you want, because I know that the dinner and the lunches in Indonesia are a little bit different from German, but we have also the stuff what you need to cook by yourself. That means you can cook in the student hostel, but you can use also our cafeterias. They have nice food, and this international food also there available. That means you need about 750 euro per month to survive in Germany. That is accommodation plus living costs.
Oh, okay, thank you for your answer. Baik, Aryo, jadi untuk tinggal di Jerman, kira-kira untuk room-nya, jadi bisa biasanya di sana menggunakan single room. Jadi satu kamar itu untuk satu orang, dan join kitchen, jadi untuk dapurnya itu bisa masak nantinya, dan bisa join. Nah, kira-kira satu bulannya itu sekitar 750 euro per bulannya untuk menghabiskan ini, apa biaya hidup di Jerman. Bagaimana dengan Aryo, apa ada tanggapan? Oke, okay, thank you. Have any question? Have the other question?
Selamat.
Mbak Vika?
Iya?
Bentar, saya mau...
Iya. Oke, Pak Bambang Pramujati, saya persilahkan ya, Pak. Langsung saja.
Ini lower hand-nya gimana? Oke. Okay. No, I just want to ask to... not ask, actually. To Norbert, probably if you can explain what's the advantages for students if they have the chance to go and do their final project in Germany, and then when they finish, do they have the chance to work in Europe or for how many years and all those things, so the student can have the idea if they have the or if they take this degree program, then they have the advantages of as compared to the regular student.
Yeah, the thing is, the students have the chance. Not everyone, okay, you need to have the money for this, it's clear, but yeah, we will, for the starting point, we'll accept 10 students per cohort coming to Germany. We will see how it goes, and we can extend it if everything is okay, but let's see. These students coming to Germany and make their final year in Germany, that means they have their practical placement, and they have the thesis. Both can they do in the same company. And that, as I mentioned before, they get good insight into German companies, how they are working, how they are doing, and the thesis is often solving a problem of the company. If the company is happy with the student, there we have many times the cases in Germany that the company is interested to hire the student. That means there will always an opportunity to get the job in this company. But even with the final certificate, you can apply for any company in Europe, in principle, not only Germany, in Europe, to get a job. You are half a year in Germany, and there are many opportunities to have a look around where you are interested. You can write some applications to companies, then you see some companies what's interesting for you, and it's not this company where you study. There's always an opportunity, but important is that you have this double degree for this. It's not, I think this will be not so easy if you have an Indonesian degree and coming to Europe, and then the first thing is they do not understand what's written there, even if you have a translation for this. Often they ask for an international accreditation. What I see before, you have some ABET accreditation, but you are now going for an ASEAN accreditation, but that's also very good if you have such an international accreditation. But if you stay in Germany, you have always a chance to find a job, to get a job in Germany. But I always recommend get a lot of international experiences, but go back to Indonesia and develop your country. Thank you very much.
One more thing, in addition to the student to have the chance to go to German for final project, I'm sure they also have the chance to go for internship only for example, for only 2 or 3 months working in the industry, something like that, just a similar to the one that they can do in Indonesia.
Even this, it's possible, no problem at all. That's totally correct.
Okay, thank you. In information for the student, that this program is also internationally accredited by the European accreditation board. I guess that's if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct, Prof. Groenewoud?
We need an accreditation.
This program is also European accredited, I guess.
Yes, must. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Terima kasih, Mbak Fika.
Okay, terima kasih, Pak Bambang dan Profesor Nobel. Untuk selanjutnya ini ada satu pertanyaan. Jadi untuk ITS, jadi di sini ada apa bedanya program joint degree dan double degree? Mungkin Dr. Unggul bisa menjawab pertanyaan.
Ya, baik. Jadi memang ini ada beberapa definisi begitu ya. Tapi joint degree yang di ITS ini mungkin bisa dibilang sama istilahnya dengan double degree kalau di masyarakat umum gitu, karena kan yang di masyarakat umum kan terkenalnya double degree. Jadi dengan mengambil program ini nanti kalau lulus dapat dua ijazah ya. Kalau ini nanti dari ITS dan juga dari instansi mitra ya gitu. Ya memang ada banyak definisi gitu ya. Tapi yang di ITS ini ya, sama istilahnya kalau di masyarakat umum itu double degree. Jadi kalau definisi lebih detail lagi itu ada yang bilang double degree itu kalau ya degree-nya itu di program studi yang berbeda. Misalnya teknik mesin dengan teknik industri, teknik mesin dengan manajemen, itu istilahnya double degree gitu ya. Kalau di yang di ITS sama dari mechanical dengan mechanical. Kalau yang tadi kan ada marine ya, marine engineering, ada naval arsitektur, sama. Cuma nanti kalau lulus dapat dua ijazah, kelebihannya itu. Nah, ini juga nilai plus juga kan, daripada satu ke Jerman sana 4 tahun atau mungkin lebih gitu ya, dengan berkuliah di ITS di Surabaya, biaya hidup di Surabaya, dapat ijazah ITS dan juga dapat ijazah dari Universitas Mitra itu. Ya, begitu Mbak Fika. Bu Fika.
Baik. Untuk Pak Bambang, apa sudah ini tercerahkan atau sudah menjawab semua pertanyaan dari Pak Bambang?
Ya, sudah, Bu Fika, matur nuwun.
Oke, baik. Saya lanjutkan di sini, ada beberapa pertanyaan lagi. Jadi saya bacakan yang dari ini Pak Priyo Heru. Nah, untuk ITS ada berapa prodi di jurusan teknik mesin? Kalau ada beberapa yang untuk IUP dan GD, apakah untuk prodi renewable energy saja? Mungkin ini untuk bidangnya ya, kalau teknik mesin ya. Mungkin ya untuk bidangnya kan ada beberapa. Nah, adakah program IUP atau joint degree-nya ini selain renewable energy gitu? Terima kasih. Mohon untuk Dr. Ato menjawab.
Ya, Pak Probo, jadi memang dulu itu ceritanya mesin ini ada 4 bidang studi ya, ada konversi energi, ada metalurgi, ada desain, ada manufaktur atau produksi begitu ya. Tetapi memang ada yang tidak ada pembidangan ya. Jadi hanya teknik mesin dan nanti final project-nya TA-nya itu adalah tinggal passion daripada anak-anak. Apakah nanti passionnya ke konversi energi atau produksi atau ke metal ataukah desain. Nah, yang untuk joint degree ini memang karena kandungan subjeknya atau mata kuliahnya itu 40% renewable energy, makanya kita kasih bidang studinya itu lebih spesifik gitu Pak Priyo. Ya, jadi yang lainnya belum. Jadi kalau yang dulu itu memang teknik mesin itu biasanya kalau di ijazahnya itu ada statementnya bidang studinya itu konversi energi, metalurgi, desain lah. Mulai tahun berapa ya Pak Bambang ya, mungkin kurikulum mulai tahun 2018 ya, atau mungkin sebelumnya ya, 2013 ya.
Untuk mulai lab itu kita sudah cukup lama, 2012-an mungkin ya, bidang studi mulai completely kita hilangkan.
Nah, jadi itu Pak, jadi kalau bidang studi dulu pernah teknik mesin itu ada 4 bidang studi, tapi kita tahun 2012 kita lebur lagi menjadi teknik mesin saja, tetapi nanti TA-nya akan masuk ke lab-lab. Nah, untuk yang renewable energy ini, karena 40% subjeknya itu renewable energy, sehingga kita berani berikan statement renewable energy begitu, Pak Priyo.
Baik, untuk Pak Priyo Heru Adiwibowo, apa ada tanggapan? Baik, kepada Pak Priyo Heru Adiwibowo, apa sudah jelas? Oke, terima kasih.
Mungkin tambahannya yang dipost tadi ya, mengasar tadi ya, itu ya. Pengalaman ya, ini saya kan lagi di Perancis ya, itu juga living cost-nya itu diberikan sama pemberi pajak itu sekitar 800 euro. Jadi hampir sama dengan yang disebutkan Nobert tadi ya, 750 ya. Nah itu kalau memang mau masak sendiri itu bisa saving itu sebenarnya. Apalagi di Perancis itu kalau mahasiswa itu ada subsidi apartemen. Nah itu malah bisa lagi gitu ya. Jadi jangan khawatir kalau orang Indonesia itu biasanya kreatif ya. Jadi kreatif biasanya dengan biaya minimal pun mungkin bisa bertahan hidup lah begitu kira-kira. Tapi kamu mungkin pengalaman ya di luar itu gitu ya.
Iya. Baik, ada pertanyaan lagi dari teman-teman, dari Bapak Ibu ataupun yang lainnya? Mungkin satu pertanyaan lagi atau dua pertanyaan lagi, apakah ada pertanyaan? Silakan jika ada pertanyaan. Oke. Kalau misalkan sudah tidak ada pertanyaan lagi, boleh kita ini Pak, apa kita tutup?
Ya, silakan.
Oke. Baiklah. Jadi terima kasih untuk para hadirin semua. Jadi kita sudah sampai ke penghujung acara. Jadi akhirnya selesai webinar hari ini, alhamdulillah. Jadi mudah-mudahan bermanfaat bagi kita semua. Jadi saya Trivika Kusuma Dewi mewakili panitia sekali lagi mengucapkan terima kasih atas kehadiran dan partisipasinya dalam acara ini. Jadi apabila ada kesalahan dan banyak kekurangan, saya mohon maaf yang sebesar-besarnya. Akhir kata, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jadi finally, finally we come to the end of this event. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your coming and your nice attention. Selamat siang dan salam sejahtera. Good afternoon all. Bye-bye and see you for next event.
Okay.
Thank you very much.